In 1939, ahead of the outbreak of the Second World War, the German Navy had sent their heavy cruiser, Admiral Graf Spee, into the Atlantic. So when the war started, she was in a perfect position to raid Allied merchant ships. The Graf Spee started raiding Allied ships in the Atlantic and along the African coast. Within a couple of months, the Graf Spee managed to sink 9 Allied vessels. The Allied response was quick. They sent out 4 aircraft carriers and more than 20 cruisers to find the German ship. On the 13th of December, a small squadron under command of Commodore Harwood found the Graf Spee close to the South American coast. The squadron consisted of the heavy cruiser Exeter, who had 6 20-centimeter guns, and the 2 light cruisers, Ajax and Achilles. The 2 ships were actually sister ships and carried 8 15-centimeter guns each. The Graf Spee was equipped with heavier guns than her opponents. She had 6 28-centimeter and 8 15-centimeter guns. Her 28-centimeter guns had a far longer range than her opponents. So the best strategy for the Graf Spee would have been to turn around and let the other ships chase her. That way she could have fired at her opponents from a safe distance, without getting into their effective range. But the German captain mistook the enemy's ships for smaller vessels and decided to attack. At 6:17, the Graf Spee fired her first shot at the Exeter. Commodore Harwood decided to split his fleet and ordered Exeter to attack from the south, while his light cruisers would stay on course. This way they could attack the Graf Spee from two sides. At 6:20, Exeter fired her first round. A couple of minutes later, she was joined by the 2 other ships. At 6:26, Exeter received a direct hit that disabled one of her turrets. Graf Spee was now firing at all of her opponents. A couple of minutes later, Exeter was hit by another 28-centimeter shell. Two of her turrets were now out of action. But Exeter managed to score a hit herself. One of her shells destroyed the fuel filter system of the Graf Spee. Without the ability to filter her diesel fuels, the Graf Spee had only reserves for 16 hours left. Kapitän Langsdorff decided to break the fight off and to turn for the next port for repairs. So he laid a smoke screen and turned to the northwest. The German ship was closely followed by the 2 light cruisers, who kept firing at her and tried to launch a torpedo attack. The Graf Spee had made a full turn and was now heading for the badly damaged Exeter again. At that point, none of the Exeter's main guns were operational, and she seemed like easy prey for the Graf Spee. But the 2 light cruisers were turning in on the German vessel. The German captain decided to leave the battlefield. Without a working fuel filter, the Graf Spee could not hope to make it back to Germany, so she went for the next port, which was the port of Montevideo. She was followed by Ajax and Achilles, while Exeter went to the Falklands for repair works. According to international naval law, the Graf Spee had to leave the port 72 hours after her arrival. It was impossible to repair the filters in that short time frame, as Captain Langsdorff didn't want to waste his men in a useless battle. He ordered them to leave the ship, sailed it into the Bay of Montevideo, where he scuttled the Graf Spee.